Jessica Chastain. This is, you know, a familiar feeling. Last year, we talked to you for the help, and it was all this buzz about your performance and the potential of awards. And now here we are, award season again, and you're right back in the mix. People talking about you again. Does it make it less nerving at all to be here, like, again, after you've experienced kind of like that whole roller coaster last year?
Yeah, it's you know what? All last year I kept saying, well, I'm never gonna have a year like this again, because this year is the best year of my life. I can't believe this. And now all of a sudden I'm saying it again. I can't believe this year. I'm never gonna have a year like this. It's just been really, really exciting. I mean, the wonderful thing about last year is I got to do a lot of press with Octavia, who I just love. I worship that woman. And whenever we would get to sit down and do press, we just laughed usually the whole time, and it was a good catch up. And this year, it's an interesting thing, because now I'm standing on my own. So it does feel a little more vulnerable. But I love this film. I love working with Kathryn and Mark, and I absolutely, I'm so inspired by the character that I play. She's a real woman who's working undercover in the CIA.
Can I be honest with you? I am bad news. I'm not your friend. I'm not gonna help you. I'm gonna break you. Any questions?
I want to make something absolutely clear. If you thought there was some working group coming to the rescue, then I want you to know that you're wrong. This is it. There's nobody else hidden away on some other floor. There is just us. And we are failing.
You really believe this story? Osama bin Laden?
Yeah.
What part convinced you?
Her confidence.
If you're right, the whole world's gonna want in on this.
You will never find him. He is one of the disappeared ones.
Now, there had to be a lot of challenges in just creating and molding this story, because there's so many secrets, and America really, you know, hasn't heard what really happened on that day. Your character, Maya, really doesn't expose all of her motivation for being in that situation. Did you think about what her motivation might have been, and what do you think?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I had 3 months before we started shooting where I called it my 3 months of school for Maya school. And I worked a lot with Mark Boal, who's our screenwriter. He started as an investigative journalist, nicknamed him the professor. And we went through everything, like anything I could learn about Maya, I did. I did a lot of reading of books, you know, reading, like, two were particularly helpful, The Looming Towers and Michael Schur's book on Osama bin Laden. Then I used my imagination to fill in any of the blanks that I couldn't find from the research, but I couldn't use my imagination as Jessica Chastain. I had to somehow keep it in track with the research I had done. So even things like, why was she recruited out of school? I had to solve that problem. You know, you see, like, in Islamabad or in Pakistan, you see, like, a child's drawing on a wall. You know, these are things that I asked for, that screensavers, postcards, American candy, certain things that I had asked for. So I would have these little reminders of the life Maya was becoming a stranger to.
Mm-hmm. Well, another great thing that this film deals with is America's feeling in the portrayal of enhanced interrogations, waterboarding, and all of that. And I think Kathryn Bigelow did a good job of being kind of ubiquitous about her opinion about it. Just from your experience with the film and all your research, do you think that those enhanced interrogations and stuff did lead to the evidence that we needed to eventually find Bin Laden, even if, you know, some years earlier? Or
I don't know. It's a really interesting question, because the scene where Maya gets the information about Abu Ahmed, where the name is first mentioned, he's not being waterboarded. They're feeding him. Mm-hmm. And I who's to say whether or not he, because of the weeks of torture, he made him in a state where he was open enough to say that. But the scene, he didn't come out from an intense interrogation. And then in opposite of that, you have, like, there's a scene where Mark Strong is talking to the White House people and saying, like, you know, we need to go in, and the response is, the president's a thoughtful man, we need proof. And he says, well, what am I supposed to do? I can't go, you've taken the detainee program away.
Right.
And I can't go to Guantanamo Bay because they're lawyered up and they'll send word to Bin Laden. So it really is a murky gray area that I think we're still learning about.
Right. Well, this is a great picture for people to just get some learning experience about experience. And it's always great to see you on screen. Can't wait to see you on Mama next year and everything else you got coming out.
Thank you. Yeah, this is real different than Celia Foote.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you so much.
We're on Wilshire Boulevard in Los Angeles, California.